Gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, according to John. Glory to you, Lord Christ. This is John chapter 15, beginning at the 9th verse. Jesus said, "As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Now remain in my love. If you keep my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands and remain in his love. I have told you this, so that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be complete. My command is this, love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you servants, because a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends. For everything that I learned from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you so that you might go and bear fruit, fruit that will last. So that whatever you ask in my name, the Father will give you. This is my command, love each other." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of God, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Please be seated. Well, welcome. It is it's wonderful to see you here this morning. And Marinella, let me call you up. And Jose, would you come join us? You see in your trifold leaflet, the news and events, kind of a bio of Marinella de la Paz, who has come and agreed to be our preacher for this morning. She is she's a chaplain at the seminary in Cuba. Her mother was the bishop of Cuba. And her father was a priest in Cuba, so she knows well her country and the state of the church in that place. And I also will say that Marinella is a little shy this morning. She's never spoken to a non-Spanish-speaking congregation. And so we want to make her feel very welcome this morning. And to help us do that, Jose Farinos is a member of our own congregation, and he also speaks some Spanish. Is that Jose? Is that correct? Just muy poco. Poquito. So all I can say is I am very grateful for Marinella to be here, and her ability to speak English far surpasses my ability to speak Spanish, so I am admiring her for her skill and her willingness to come and be with us. So let's say a prayer, shall we? Lord God, we give you thanks for your body, the church around the world, that raises up leaders and that fills us with a passion for your gospel to be able to see lives change. So thank you for Marinella and her willingness to come and to bring your word. Thank you for Jose and his willingness to serve. Just be with us and fill us with your spirit, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's make her feel welcome, shall we?
Les saludo en nombre de la comunidad San Felipe Diácono, donde sirvo como ministra en Cuba. Ellos también estarán hoy orando por ustedes.
Greetings. On behalf of San Felipe Deacon Community in Cuba, where I serve as minister, they are praying for you today.
Quiero agradecer la gentileza del Reverendo Tutsediver por su invitación a estar esta mañana aquí con ustedes para proclamar la palabra de Dios.
I want to thank the kindness of Reverend Todd Sederberg for the invitation to be here with you this morning to proclaim the Word of God.
Hoy es un domingo muy especial, porque celebramos el Día de las Madres. Reciban todas las madres de esta comunidad mis felicitaciones, y la extiendo a todas aquellas mujeres que sin haber concebido un hijo, Dios les ha dado la sabiduría para guiar y sostener a niños y jóvenes a través de su vida.
Today is a very special Sunday. We celebrate Mother's Day. Congratulations to all the mothers of this community and to all those women who may have not conceived a child, but God has given them the wisdom to guide and support children and young people through their lives.
En este capítulo 15 del Evangelio de San Juan, Jesús nos enseña acerca de las demandas del discipulado. Y en su primera parte nos explica la relación de Jesús con su padre y el resultado de esa relación.
In chapter 15 of the Gospel of John, Jesus teaches us about the demands of discipleship, and in the first part explained the relationship of Jesus with his Father and the result of that relationship.
La idea clave de este pasaje es que no han sido los discípulos los que han sido escogidos por Dios. La iniciativa parte de Dios, Él es quien ha escogido a sus discípulos.
The key to this passage is that it was not the disciples who chose God. The initiative was God's. He is the one who chose his disciples.
Dios nos ha escogido con propósitos claros y todos son frutos de una nueva relación con Él.
God has chosen us with a clear purpose, which is fruit of the new relationship with Him.
Esta relación parte de su mandato, permaneced en mi amor. Este término abarca los dos anteriores, permaneced en mí, permaneced en mi palabra, mencionados en la primera parte del capítulo que no pertenecen al fragmento de hoy. En resumen, que esto significa permanecer en Él y sus palabras, lo cual habla de tres dimensiones de esta relación. La relación de Jesús con su Padre, la relación de Jesús con la comunidad y la relación de la comunidad con Él.
This relationship is part of his mandate, remain in my love. This term encompasses the former remain in me, remain in my word, mentioned in the first part of the chapter, which does not belong in today's lecture. In short, it means to abide in him and his words, which speaks of the three dimensions of the relationship, of this relationship. The relationship between Jesus and his Father, the relationship of Jesus with the community, and the community's relationship with Jesus.
Por eso podemos decir que Dios nos ha escogido para varias cosas, pero vamos a decir hoy solo tres.
We can say that God has chosen us for many things, but today we're going to focus on only three.
Primera, para el gozo. Entendemos gozo como mucho más que alegría. El gozo es un profundo sentido de seguridad que nace de una apropiada relación con Dios.
First, for joy. We understand joy as much more than happiness. Joy is a deep sense of security that comes from a proper relationship with God.
Esta relación, en ocasiones se manifiesta celebrándolo públicamente, y otras mostrando una absoluta confianza en Dios, a pesar de las circunstancias más adversas.
This relationship is sometimes manifested as a public celebration, and others showing complete trust in God despite the most adverse circumstances.
Es contradictorio un cristiano amargado, desanimado, todo el tiempo. Tenemos un himno que dice, no puede estar triste el corazón que tiene a Cristo, no puede estar triste el corazón que tiene a Dios. No vivo yo, mas vive Cristo en mí.
It is contradictory to think of a Christian embittered and discouraged all the time. We have a hymn that says, a heart that has Christ cannot be sad. A heart that has God cannot be sad. I do not live, but Christ lives in me.
Para mí el vivir es morir. Para mí el vivir es Cristo. Que nos habla de ese gozo profundo que nace de la certeza de que Dios camina a nuestro lado y está en nosotros.
For me, to live is to die. For me, to live is Christ. That speaks of the deep joy that comes from the certainty that God walks with us and in us.
Segundo, hemos sido escogidos para el amor. Y esto quiere decir que Jesús nos envía al mundo para que nos amemos unos a los otros, no para que vivamos conforme a los esquemas de competencias y discusiones del mundo.
Second, we have been chosen to love. This means that Jesus sends us into the world to love one another and not to live according to patterns of competition and discussions about the world.
Estamos llamados a vivir de tal manera que mostremos con nuestro testimonio de vida lo que significa amar a nuestros semejantes.
We are called to live so that we show with our testimony of life what means to love our neighbors.
Tercero, Jesús nos ha llamado para que seamos sus amigos. Aunque ser esclavo de Dios era un título de honor, y así lo sintieron Moisés, Josué y David, hasta el apóstol Pablo se sintió orgulloso de ese título.
Third, Jesus has called us to be his friends. Although being a slave of God was a title of honor, and so felt Moses, Joshua, and David, even the Apostle Paul was proud of that title.
Sin embargo, Jesús nos dice que tiene algo mejor para nosotros, que ya no seremos esclavos, sino amigos de Él.
However, Jesus tells us that He has something better for us, that we will not be slaves, but friends of His.
La amistad con Jesús cambia la naturaleza de la relación. Los esclavos no tenían derecho a presentarse delante de sus amos. Los amigos tienen acceso directo. Jesús nos ha ofrecido una nueva relación con Dios, una relación de amistad cálida y cercana.
Jesus tells us that He has something better for us, that we will not be slaves of friends of His. Our friendship with Jesus changes the nature of the relationship. Slaves were not allowed to be in the presence of their masters. Friends have a direct access to them. Jesus has offered us a new relationship with God, a relationship of friendship, warmth, and closeness.
Quiero contarles una historia que recibí en mi correo. Cuentan que en la ciudad de Chicago, una noche invernal, había un niño vendiendo periódicos en un rincón intentando protegerse del frío. Estaba con temor de congelarse, porque no vendía mucho y el frío era cada vez mayor.
I want to tell you a story that I received one day in my email. It said that on a cold winter night in the city of Chicago, there was a boy selling newspapers on a corner trying to keep warm. He was afraid to freeze because he had not sold too many newspapers and it was getting colder.
Se acercó a un policía que pasaba por allí y le preguntó, Señor, ¿habrá un refugio por aquí cerca donde pueda pasar la noche? Casi siempre duermo en una caja de cartón en aquel callejón, pero el frío es muy fuerte.
He approached a policeman who was passing by and asked, Sir, is there a shelter around here where I could spend the night? I usually sleep in a cardboard box in the alley, but today is very cold.
El policía le miró y le dijo, Baja por esa calle, hasta una casa blanca, toca la puerta, y cuando te abran solo dices, Juan 15, 12. El niño así lo hizo. Abrió la puerta a una señora, y el niño dijo, Juan 15, 12.
The policeman looked at him and said, Go down that street until you find the white house and knock on the door. When they open, just say, John 15, 12. The boy did as he was told. A lady opened the door and the boy said, John 15, 12.
Ella le hizo pasar enseguida y le invitó a sentarse junto a la chimenea en un cómodo asiento. Luego salió de la habitación y el niño pensó, La verdad es que no entiendo eso de Juan 15, 12, pero parece ser bueno para que un niño no muera de frío en la calle.
She let him in immediately and invited him to sit by the fireplace in a comfortable seat. Then she left the room, and the boy thought, The truth is, I do not understand what John 15:12 means, but it seems to be good for a child not to freeze on the street.
Luego la señora regresó y le preguntó al niño si deseaba comer. Él aceptó gustosamente. Hacía días que no comía. Lo llevó a la mesa servida con deliciosos alimentos. Él comió hasta sentirse satisfecho y pensó, Sigo sin entender... Pero Juan 15, 12 llena un estómago hambriento.
Then the lady came back and asked the boy if he wanted to eat. He accepted willingly since he had not eaten for days. She took him to a table full of delicious food. He ate until he felt satisfied and thought, I still don't understand, but John 15, 12 sure feels a hungry stomach.
Pudo tomar un reconfortante baño tibio y vestir ropa limpia. La señora lo tapó, le dio un beso en la frente antes de dormir. Él se fue quedando dormido mientras pensaba que Juan 15, 12 podría hacer muchas cosas buenas por un niño cansado.
He then took a soothing bath and was given clean clothes. The lady covered him and gave him a kiss on the forehead before putting him to sleep. He drifted off to sleep thinking that John 15, 12 could do many good things for a tired child.
Al otro día el niño recibió el mismo esmerado trato. En la noche la señora lo llevó junto a la chimenea y le preguntó, ¿Entiendes qué es Juan 15, 12? El niño le respondió que nunca había oído hasta que el policía le dijo que se lo dijera cuando tocara su puerta y le abriera.
The next day, the child received the same attentive treatment. At night, the lady took him by the fireplace and asked, "Do you understand what John 15:12 is?" The boy replied that he had never heard it until the police told him to say it when she opened the door.
La señora abrió la Biblia y leyó Juan 15:12. "Este es el mandamiento mío, que se amen los unos a los otros como yo los he amado." Allí comenzó a explicarle al niño sobre Jesús. Ese día el niño entendió y entregó su vida a Jesús.
The lady opened the Bible and read John 15:12. "This is my command, love one another as I have loved you." Then she began to talk about Jesus. That day, the boy understood and dedicated his life to Jesus.
No es posible atraer a otros a la vida cristiana sin mostrar el fruto de la vida cristiana. Jesús nos envía a no intentar fabricar cristianos a base de discusiones inútiles y de miedos prefabricados, sino que nos invita a ser ejemplos de luz para los demás en nuestra manera de amarles y servirles.
It is not possible to attract others to the Christian life without showing the fruit of the Christian life. Jesus sends us not to make Christians on the basis of useless debates or unreasonable fear, but invites us to be examples of light for others in the way we love them and serve them.
Que podamos seguir escuchando la voz de Dios, invitándonos a ejercitar el amor con nuestros semejantes y así dar testimonios de su amor en el mundo.
Let's listen to the voice of God inviting us to exercise our love with our neighbors and thus bear witness to his love in the world.
Amen.
Amen.